Well, welcome to DazMode Home Theater Build Part 2. Today, as I promised you last time, I'm going to have a look on PC60 case sponsored by Lian Li. I haven't worked with this model before, so it will be quite interesting to see what's inside. And also, we'll be comparing it to my existing home theater build based out of Antec Fusion case. Straight out of the box, I get the case itself, the sheet with advertising for a variety of Lian Li accessories you can get it in addition to a purchase, an installation guide, which seems to have quite a plenty of pictures describing how to install the unit. So, if you need something like this, it's definitely a good item to have. Not sure if there are any additional accessories inside, so I'll just open it with you right now and we'll have a look. Alright, yes, definitely something here. Let's have a look what we get in additional box. USB adapter, speaker, beeper, and a few screws for motherboard and installation of the hard drives. That's pretty much it. Some piece of paper inside, but that's all I have right now. So let me review internals and how they work for the intended application that we're looking for. Let's like make small change in my original plan. Instead of disassemble the case and look inside, let's look outside of the case and see what kind of features is exhibited from its exterior. One thing that I noticed right away, that when I was reading technical specification of this model, that unlike many other home theater or desktop type of cases, it's accept full size ATX motherboard. You can see this my EVGA demo board that I use in most of my videos, and there's no problem to put it all. So, if you want to create not home theater type of computer, but something which is probably a little bit bigger and more powerful, there's a room to put a proper system in, and if cooling will be adequate to work through it, you can create pretty interesting computer in different form factor from the typical tower cases that you see everywhere. Quick peek underneath of the case, you can see that legs is very nice, so they will go well with your audio video equipment you probably have in your living room, so there's no need to do anything in that department. If you use it as desktop, I guess probably it's not as matter much, but still nice to have something better than typical black rubber feet that just glued on the bottom of the case. Moving along to the side of the case, I'd like to show you that provisioning of side fans on this model is 140 mm. So you have a potential to put slower speed fans with the same characteristics as a faster 120 mm fans. This feature is not available for many cases in this form factor. Most of the cases go with a standard 120 mm or even 80 mm, which is much more noisy. So there's definite benefit. One thing to mention that, as you can see, here we have a provisioning for the power supply, so here there no fan can be installed because basically this place is taken by power supply and they didn't even drill any holes here, so the only fan goes on this side of the case is this position. This position is just decorative and allows you to get some air from or to power supply system. Front of the case pretty critical when you build home theater computer, because that's what you actually will see all the time, right under your TV and next to your audio video equipment. Nothing wrong with the case, very strong conservative looks, maybe not as flashy as other models. For example, for my Antec, I have a additional LCD window that I can run clock or news. It's not really usable, but a little bit adds to the appearance, and I also have dial button that I never use, but it goes really well with audio video receiver. So this is nothing here. It wouldn't be striking out as a foreign object, but at the same time doesn't bring much attention either. One thing that I would change if I would be Lian Li, I would try to camouflage more those connectors on the front. You can see that this connector is black, but those two blue. And I would make them black too. And possibly even paint the metal parts as well. Because basically, if you don't show anything, don't show. Just hide entire thing. So those two, obviously, they color-coded for mic and your headset. And again, I would rather have them black and have some other means of showing which one is which, rather than definitely give away the fact this is basically a PC sitting on your shelf. Button itself looks really upscale. Kind of dark gunmetal color. I assume they probably will glow as well, and I think they kind of blue, but we'll see it later. This part is really look nice. So if we will have hidden this part of connectors, I think that would be totally perfect way to make home see the PC. But I don't think it's a deal breaker. Looking so on the right side of exterior of the case, we can see provision for another 240mm fans. And there's something I'd like to mention. I missed it when I look on the other side of the computer. There's additional holes here for 120mm fans. So pros to Lian Li that they allow you to install both sizes of the fans. So you can choose 140, or if you don't like it for any reason, 120 will work for this case as well, which is pretty good. Another thing that I'd like to point you that all fans, two here and one other side, coming with the filters. This is quite critical for home theater application. I noticed that usually you don't touch this kind of computer for a really long time, more than a year. You just install, everything works, and that's it, you just use it. So when you finally decide to open your computer, disconnect all cables, it's a big hassle. And clean it, you have so much stuff inside, it's not even funny. So the fact that you have additional filters that will protect internals of computer from the dust is a really, really good idea. I would recommend to put filters for any home theater computer, and here it's just coming straight out of the box, which is, I really like it. Another provisioning fan on the top, we can see this, it looks like 140mm here. So when we put this panel back on the computer, we have another fan that blowing straight on the motherboard area on the CPU, around the CPU. So we have two fans in, two fans out, which is proper balance. Generally speaking, I would always recommend that you have pump more air inside, and so air get pushed out of the case all the time, because usually if you have a opposite balance, negative pressure, you will have a lot of dust on your connectors, like USB and audio video. So it's not a good idea. So better if stuff get pushed out of the case. So that might lead you to make an unbalanced type of the fans, like exhaust slower fans and pumping in bigger fans. It might help with this problem. Alright, so that's all I can say about externals, and let's turn the case and see what we have inside of it. Here we have a case on its front, and we can see what we have inside. So all this provisioning for your optical drives and your hard drives area is just bare aluminum, it's not anodized. Could be nice to have everything black, but I don't think it's very critical, because it's not a showcase computer, has no windows, you can't really see, and as I said before, you assemble it, use it, and you never look inside until something breaks. Definitely not a toolless installation. I see that to remove those cages, I need to unscrew all those screws out in order to take them away and put my motherboard in. What I can see here, I'll try to lower it for you. So you can see that provisioning on this area is a 3 full-size hard drives. And there's another three hard drives there. So for such a small case, you can have as much as 6 hard drives, which is not bad. For if you're running really like media library and something that requires massive storage characteristics, you have it. Like, put 2 terabytes in each slot. This is a lot of music, right? On the front, two provisioning for CD-ROMs or whatever 525 device. I personally, what I think I will do is, obviously I need a Blu-ray player, but here I probably put something like a size camera panel, so I can see some have some additional readers for memory cards, or maybe hot swappable small laptop size hard drive. So if I need to bring some files or something, or something that bigger than what can be put on a USB stick, sticking hard drives in is totally priceless. You can move a large amount of data, and the laptop hard drives as big as 1 terabyte right now. So this is a lot of stuff you can move in and out with the computer without any cables dingling around from external hard drive system. Okay, last thing that I would like to walk through, something that we're not going to do, but we can discuss it a little. Just looking on the internals of the case, and let's say I would speculate if I want to make this system still water-cooled. What is my options? Basically, we have three fans. So, in terms of placing radiators, we're limited to one radiator in this area, and possibly dual radiator in that area. I think that it's how it looks for me. This is pretty tight. I almost guarantee that it's no space to put a single, even thin radiator on the right side of the case with fans. That probably wouldn't work at all. Also, spacing seems odd. So, if you're going to make water-cooled system, probably the only way you can create it is to have either one single 140 or 120 millimeter radiator on this side. Make sure you have a short power supply, not interfere with it. And maybe you can put one radiator here, definitely not in this area, and see if it will interfere with memory slots or not. So this is a big question mark. This definitely can work out. So if you have a custom PC or even pre-filled solution, like Corsair pre-filled solution, that's workable. So you can have a radiator mounted here on all tubes, and there's enough of space. You need to make sure you don't go into user hard drives, but I think it's a doable solution. And again, as I mentioned a couple times, I don't think it's warranted for what I'm doing, just watching video and music, so I will stick to air-cooled system. And next step, we'll start disassembling it and start installing computer itself. But that's going to be a separate video. Thank you for watching, and see you soon with the next chapter.